Yes, America's best National Hockey League talent has come together and is ready for the World Cup. Tonight, it's the final tune-up. Team USA taking on Slovakia. Next. Live from the Civic Center in Providence, Rhode Island, Prime Network presents World Cup Hockey. Hello, everybody. I'm Brenda Brennan. Glad you could join us here tonight. The World Cup, the former Canada Cup. The premise is the same, but the name has been changed as a stepping stone to selling the sport globally. Nearly 150 NHLers will be carrying their country's colors in this competition, some of the game's greatest stars. But this is no all-star game. No, this is a battle for world supremacy. Tonight, Team USA hooks up with Team Slovakia, and the Americans have an extra advantage with a late addition to the squad. For more on that story, we head upstairs to Dale Arnold and Gord Kluzak.
Friend of my Canadian pal's getting a little nervous here, I think. Team USA did get stronger this afternoon. The Norris Trophy winner arrived late this afternoon. Chris Chelios from the Chicago Blackhawks will step right into the lineup tonight.
And he'll strengthen what I think is already the strongest defensive core in this tournament with guys like Brian Leetch, the Hatcher brothers, Phil Housley. Chris Chelios, outstanding in both ends of the rink, been tested internationally, been in big game situations, and he'll really be a leader on that team for Team USA.
When you think of offensive leaders for Team USA, and if I asked you which guy had the best offensive season a year ago, I bet you'd come up with five or six guesses before you came up with Doug Weight. But the bottom line is, this is the only guy for Team USA who had more than 100 points a year ago.
USA has a lot of firepower up front. Doug Weight is one of those players. Really gifted player, very elusive, strong skater, sees the ice extremely well. Playing with Brett Hull, he'll get him the puck when he needs it, and they should really put up some numbers in this tournament.
As far as Team Slovakia is concerned, a number of NHL players. One big line in particular, left to right, Zygmunt Palfy, Joseph Stumpel, and the big gun on the right wing, Peter Bondra.
Outstanding speed. I think Team Slovakia, the only chance they're going to have is those guys get a couple of big goals, play very tight defensive hockey. They can't get into a wide open game with any team in their part of the draw.
It's Team USA and Team Slovakia facing off next in the Providence Civic Center here on Prime. Today wraps up its World Cup exhibition schedule, taking on Slovakia before what is not a half house, a bit of a sparse crowd, but those who are in attendance are revved up and ready to go. Gordy, we were noticing before the game there were as many Slovakia flags in the building as there were USA flags.
Well, Slovakia has only been a country now since 1993, so those fans get out and cheer for them when they get the opportunity.
Two teams lining up at their respective blue lines. It will be a red, white, and blue party down there on the ice tonight as Slovakia is also garbed in a royal blue uniform with red and white trim. Team USA in their white jerseys, red pants, and the blue trim as well. Now, what we are told is going to happen is that we are going to have both the Slovakian and American national anthems after the ceremonial gift exchange between Peter Bondra and Brian Leetch, two guys who have had the opportunity to play against each other on 50 or 60 occasions in their career.
Arch rivals, the Rangers and Capitals.
Now we will start with the Slovakian national anthem, which is called what, my friend?
Lightning Over Tatras.
Corps' closet today, he had to go with the subdued look. Both the Slovakian and American national anthems, the officials assigned by World Hockey for tonight's exhibition game. Gord Brosseker and Shane Heyer will work the lines. Mark Fawcett will be your referee for tonight's game. That's the guy who's supposed to play most of the games in net for Slovakia. Jaromir Dragon, but he will not start tonight's game. Igor Murin will. Down at the other end of the ice, Mike Richter will get the call for Team USA. They have been splitting goaltending chores, but I talked with Coach Paul Holmgren last night. He thought that Richter might even go the whole game tonight. Goaltenders generally like to do that if they can, as opposed to playing two periods and splitting it up 2-1, that sort of thing. And Richter, according to Paul Holmgren, will probably play the whole game. That's Igor Murin. He's going to get the start for Slovakia. Last year, he played for Trenčín Dukla. Played 35 games, 2.52 or 2.74 goals against average, excuse me. And Murin is supposed to be the backup for the most part, getting an opportunity to play here tonight against Team USA.
Team USA with Mike Richter, Jim Carrey, certainly strong in net. Imagine the coaching staff, Ron Wilson, who's the head coach, will look to see who has the hot hand, and if one goalie really gets it going, they'll stay with him through most of the tournament.
Ron Wilson, of course, coming home for this exhibition game. He's a Providence College product, as is the team's general manager, Lou Lamorella. Set, go to work here in the first period.
They needed to call some of their friends to come on out to the game.
Brian Smolinski and Joseph Stumpel, former teammates with the Boston Bruins, face this one off, and we're underway. Jurgis Bochka goes to Team USA's blue line. Brian Leach wearing the captain's C, gets to Matthew Schneider. Grew up just up the road a piece in Woonsocket, Rhode Island. Breaking Bondra offsides at Team USA's blue line. 14 seconds into the first, no score. You said this line needed to get a quick lightning-type goal early on and hope they could hold on defensively. He could give it to him.
Peter Bondra is just one of the most explosive players in the National Hockey League. Scored 50 goals this year. Just give him a little seam and he'll go right through it.
Robert Schvela, who had a terrific season for the Stanley Cup finalist, Florida Panthers, tried to clear an offensive zone, broken up there. Nice play by Tony Amonte, clears it in, will get an icing call as Bochka touches up.
Team USA has been quite a travel schedule, Vancouver, San Jose, Detroit. Finally get here and have a few days off. Their first game is in Philadelphia next Saturday. So we'll have a little time to sort of get back to normal, but it's been quite rigorous so far.
Guy on the left, John LeClair, will be a popular guy in that Saturday game, morning in Philadelphia. Star for the Philadelphia Flyers this past year, 51 goals in 82 games. Gary Suter.
You won't have the same comfort in Philadelphia, though, when Lindros will be lined up on the other side of the ice.
Brad Paul works it ahead. Doug Waite can't quite come up with it. Breaking Slovakia on sides. Deke Richter, great save. Lubomir Kolnik rocked point blank. Doug Waite tips it out of the zone. Kolnik sent in alone at the blue line. I think for a moment Team USA thought it might have been offsides, was not called. Offensive zone by USA. Jan Varkulik back, gets plastered, clears it up the boards, length of the ice. Touched up Darian Hatcher, icing cold against Slovakia.
Team USA a little sloppy defensively here. Turnovers in the neutral zone. Slovakia doing a good job counterattacking, but Mike Richter, technically sound goaltender, comes out, plays the angle. Stays right with the puck carrier here. A little deep to his backhand. Richter just stays right with him. Flashes that pad out. Team USA again, a little sloppy. Couple of times, let players get in behind them.
Bill Housley, near wing centering pass. Deflected by Mike Madonna, wide to the corner. Penalty call upcoming against Slovakia. Loose front save by Murin. Players dump. Holding will be the call. Holding the stick will be the call. Not sure if it's Pavel Dimitra who got caught or Jan Varholik.
I think those type of plays happen quite a bit more frequently in Europe, sort of holding the stick. The National Hockey League has really tried to crack down on those things. National Hockey League referees are going to be all over the European players to try to get away with that.
Stanislav Jasechko gets the call. 2 minutes for holding the stick at 1:26 of the first period. USA on the power play for the first time tonight. Team USA with a man advantage. Brian Leach back to Phil Housley at the line. Housley, far wing, lead shot, whistle wide of Mirren's net by Mike Madonna. Leach tried to go back to Madonna, far circle. Madonna's got Adam Detmarsh jockeying in front with Smolinski. Shot saved, Mirren. Smolinski rebound covered up as well. Brian Smolinski gets the gloves up with Robert Schvela. They step in to separate them quickly.
Team USA, I think for the first time in this tournament, in the history of this tournament, has more offensive firepower than ever before. Players like Mike Madonna, he had a great Canada Cup in 91, but now at 25 years old, you expect him to even be more dominant. Gets a shot through the screen, they're trying to move the puck around the perimeter. Gets Smolinski and Detmarsh to crash the net, look for rebound.
Face-off game back to the Team USA blue line where Housley awaits. Mike Madonna, Smolinski tips to the corner. Scott Young lost it. Grab there, carried out by Bondra. Blue line blast, Richter pad save. Backhand flip, Richter made the stop on the rebound off of Botchka's stick. USA breaks, Housley center ice. Slips it past Botchka into the corner. Schvela plays it far corner. Deflects off the Team USA stick. Joseph Stumpel tried to send Bondra breaking shorthanded. Housley off the skate of Leach. Scott Young back to Housley. Bill Housley, far side, ref all can't control. Joseph Stumpel clears it down. 45 seconds left in the Team USA power play. Great feed right wing. In a low, wait, backhand score!
One thing Team USA has is an abundance of speed. And they hit the neutral zone like this. Doug Wade going wide on the outside, just gets a stride on the Slovakian defenseman and a beautiful backhand right up over the glove of Mirren. It's very difficult to do to sort of cut that puck in your backhand and then fire it up short side, but Doug Wade, extremely skilled, did it beautifully.
Terrific backhand flip from Brett Hull sent Wade in alone. Power play goal for Team USA. They've taken a 1-0 lead.
At least it was difficult for me to do.
Trust me, if it was hard for you, think what it was like for me. Steve Konowalczyk comes offensive zone. Bill Guerin check far wing. Konowalczyk. Back to the blue line. Chris Chelios making his first appearance for Team USA. Sean McEckert can't quite get it in the near corner. Slovakia plays to the near wing. Konowalczyk, McEckert behind the net, centering pass off the skate of Guerin. Babushka, near side feed, Miroslav Shatan's shot blocked away, far corner. Konowalczyk tips it wing boards. Team USA clears it out. Robert Schvela comes back in. Schvela for Slovakia, waiting for a line change. Flex out of the zone for the moment. McEcker now right wing flip looking for Tony Amonte.
What a pickup Robert Schvela was for the Florida Panthers, getting him through Calgary last year for a fifth round pick. Set a points record for Florida for assists. Just was a key ingredient for Florida's success last year.
Kevin Hatcher for Gary Suter in the corner. He gets checked immediately. Otto Hash check over there for Slovakia. That's number 10 in blue. Can't come up with it. Hatcher goes back boards and staples his man. Holding got plastered back boards for Dimitra. Pavel Dimitra. Centering feed. Shot wide of the net. Zdeno Seeger flipped it wide. USA's Tony Amonte clears it out. Length of the ice, but no icing call.
The Slovakian team is mostly European. I mean, they play in Europe. Few NHLers. So most of those players are used to operating on the big ice surface. They're going to run out of room quickly in the corners.
Matthew Schneider for USA. Mike Madonna, great feed, right wing. Guerin drive, save Mirren. Near point, Schneider keeps it in. Guerin tries to slip it loose to Madonna. Checked away to the corner. Mike Madonna. Check. Toss cleared out of the zone by Slovakia. Length of the ice. Back to retrieve. Darian Hatcher. Matthew Schneider. Lost it. Centering pass. Blocked in front by Hatcher. Darian Hatcher dove in front of that drive. Olnick turned towards the net. Schneider checked in the corner. Darian Hatcher. Four checking. Zdeno Seeger. Mike Madonna out. Rolled off the end of the stick. Olnick grabs it back. Gives to Seeger. Shot. Left hand save. Richter. Backhand flip. USA breaks. Scott Young up with Doug Waite. Broken up at the Slovakian blue line. Back out comes Slovakia. He's Bondra. Trying to get loose in front. Got checked off the play. Bondra goes to the corner to retreat. Kevin Hatcher for Scott Young. Kept in Sigmund Halpy. Shot blocked. Loose in front. Bondra turns. Forehand wristed wide. Bar point. Bar pulling. Feed off a skate. Rebound. Turned wide of the net by Halpy. USA comes out. Sean McEachern. McEachern in with Young. McEachern carries. Centering pass. In the skates of Young. Couldn't shoot. Joseph Stumpel for Slovakia. Tried to send Bondra breaking again. We'll get an icing call. Back to touch it up is Brian Leach. We're at the Providence Civic Center here in Providence. Team USA on the Doug Waite power play goal has taken a 1-0 lead over Slovakia. You're watching the game here on Prime. Team USA leads Slovakia 1-0 here at the Providence Civic Center. World Cup of Hockey coming your way on Prime. Dale Arnold, Gordy Kluzak, Brenda Brennan. Happy to be with you here on a Sunday evening. That's Igor Murin, who yielded that backhand goal by Doug Waite on the power play. Brett Hull and Phil Housley picked up the assists on the goal, by the way. USA with it. That's Housley carrying deep. Shot off the outside of the net. Cleared to the blue line. Kept in by Suter. John LeClair. Corner of Monty. Centering pass. Murin cut it off with the stick. Covered it up long enough for the faceoff. Mark Fossett with a quick whistle when he lost sight of the puck.
Big power forwards like John LeClair and Billy Guerin. Slovakia does not have that much size in the blue line. Those guys are really going to be able to establish position around the net. Make it very difficult to move them out of there. Tony Amonte, great balance. There you see LeClair and Guerin just standing in there, very strong. And they've got the deft touch as well.
Down off sides. Nope, we've got a penalty call here. I believe it's going to go against Matthew Schneider. Schneider's going to get the slashing call, and Slovakia will get the power play.
I heard the referee say number five, and I thought that probably means a Slovakian penalty because he couldn't pronounce the name, but I was wrong.
Well, it's actually sort of funny. There's a 29 out there on the ice for Slovakia. There's no 29 in our roster. They were very accommodating downstairs, trying to help me as I got together with the people from the Slovakian team. They were very willing. They were just not really able to communicate quite the way they liked. Darian Hatcher, shorthand, can't clear. Sakaris into the corner. Sticks up high from Hatcher, not called. Hatcher able to muscle it out between the defense pair, length of the ice.
Paul Holmgren told me that Darian Hatcher played extremely well thus far, defensively being a real physical presence as well.
Shot, Richter, stick save, covers it up as Otto Haschek gets carried into him.
Not quite sure what Team Slovakia did, though, to get put in the draw they're in with Russia, Canada, and the U.S., probably the three top teams in the tournament. Slovakia ends up getting thrown in that, what you would call the North American division. Going to be very lucky to even get a tie in the round-robin competition.
Slovakia on the power play. Shvela can't keep it in. Tries to slow up Scott Young unsuccessfully. Centering pass, Deadmarsh. Couldn't knock it out of the air. Adam Deadmarsh, one of two players on Team USA, born in Canada. Deadmarsh, born in Trail, British Columbia. The other, Brett Hull, born in Belleville, Ontario.
So why are they on Team USA? Can you explain that
both
to me?
Both dual citizenship and elected to play for Team USA. Shvela shot blocked at the line. Drops it off. Zygmunt Palk, cross ice, Botchka. Deadmarsh slid out, got the stick in the skates of Botchka, got away with one. Centering pass, Bondra drive, blocked. Backhand flip, cleared by Adam Deadmarsh.
Mike Richter's had to make a number of good saves way out of his net, cutting down the angle, handling the rebounds extremely well.
Peter Bondra slides it loose. Otto Haschek. In the corner for Zygmunt Kalpin. Drive blocked wide. Darian Hatcher takes it far wing. Puck cleared over the shoulder of the defenseman.
What a year Zygmunt Kalpin had for the New York Islanders. 43 goals, 44 assists. Very determined player, not afraid to get his nose dirty.
Into the zone comes Kolnick. Centering feed by Kolnick, blocked. Team USA slides it out. It's Matthew Schneider just out of the penalty box. USA back at full strength. John LeClaire. Diamante can't pull it away from Sakaris, who clears it away to the USA blue line. Kevin Hatcher. Off there. Seeger left it near point. Matty Buchna's shot blocked. Back in. Slovakia shot, saved. Richter as he robs. Lubomir Kolnick point blank. Kolnick shaking his head. Team USA leading Team Slovakia 1-0 at the Providence Civic Center here in Providence, Rhode Island.
Defenseman standing up on the play. Sakaris, quick transition. Creates a good scoring opportunity at the end of that for Slovakia, with Mike Richter again making a great save on Lubomir Kolnick, who broke in.
Joseph Moskar on the draw for Slovakia. Slovakia center behind Team USA's net. Mike Madonna breaks out. Dumps it deep. Near in. Tried to push it to the corner. Fanned on it. Bill Guerin working in the corner. Babuchka plays it away to the far side. Slovakia's Jan Varholik into the corner. Taken out of it. Chelios. Richard Zednik for Slovakia. Out to center ice. Clears it behind Mike Richter's net. Richter plays it left wing. Robert Shvela for Slovakia. Back at his own blue line for Jurgis Botchka. Shvela. Just inside the line. Nice little slip pass loose. Got it free to Pavel Dimitra. Back to Shvela, who shot it wide. USA's Matthew Schneider. Back on the far corner, Schneider. Brett Hull tried to backhand it to the line. Shvela kept it in. Shot blocked wide. Haschek can't come up with it. That's Gary Suter for USA. USA breaking through center ice. Wade into the zone with Hull. Centering pass into the skates of Hull from Scott Young. Dimitra. Hits the line. Shot went through the skates of Richter. As Sakaris put it on net, Richter made the skate save. Didn't know he had it. It trickled wide of the net. Brett Hull back now for USA. Into the corner, Sakaris spilled. No penalty call. Back to the blue line. Darian Hatcher shot off a pair of skates to the far wing. Amonte deep. Can't connect with Smolinski. Brian Leach. Just able to keep it in. into the corner. LeClaire throws a shoulder, looks for Amonte, deep, had it blocked. LeClaire takes it back. LeClaire backhand shot deflected far wing. Darian Hatcher into the corner. Penalty call coming up to Slovakia. Shot blocked, backhand flip save, rebound score, Darian Hatcher. Delayed penalty call on, Hatcher buries the third rebound. Team USA takes a 2-0 lead over Slovakia.
Team USA dominating the one-on-one battles in the corner, really controlling the puck when they get it in deep on Slovakia. With a delayed penalty call coming, all five USA players on the ice will go towards the net. You see Darian Hatcher gets the rebound left wide open. Just puts it over to Murin, who had no chance on the play.
I believe it'll be LeClaire and Smolinski on the assist. Darian Hatcher gets the goal. Comes at 12:45 of the first. USA, Sean McEachern breaks offensive zone. Steve Konowalczyk, backhand save, here in. Housley's shot deflected away. Zygmunt Palfi breaks out with Bondra, joined by Stumpel. This play by Hatcher at center ice to tie up Palfi. Palfi comes in, offside ball, and a huge check thrown at the blue line by Adam Detmarch sends Palfi flying. 6:50 left to play here in the first period. It's Team USA leading Slovakia 2-0.
A couple of young National Hockey League stars collide here. Ziggy Palfi going full speed over the blue line. Doesn't see Adam Detmarch until it's too late. Detmarch just puts that shoulder right in under his chin. Knocks him flying.
Team USA leads Slovakia 2-0. You're at the Civic Center in Providence, Rhode Island. Dale Arnold, Gordy Kluzak, Brenda Brennan bringing you the game here on Prime. Doug Waite and Darian Hatcher scoring for Team USA. Waite on the power play, Hatcher on a delayed penalty call a moment ago. That's Steve Konowalczyk from the Washington Capitals. Set to take the face-off against Joseph Stumpel of the Boston Bruins. Matty Buchna, who was supposed to be wearing number 11, but is wearing Joseph Dano's number 29. Cleared it behind the net. USA, McEachern missed the pass, rolled wide of Murin's net. Bondra touches up the icing call.
Peter Bondra, who was actually mentioned Detmarch and Hall being born in a country that they're not representing. Bondra was born in Kiev, Ukraine, moved to Slovakia when he was about 3 years old. Very happy to represent this young country.
You see the 52 goals that he scored with Washington. He was a holdout early in the year, played with the Detroit Vipers of the IHL. In 7 games, had 8 goals and an assist for 9 points. That'll generally end your holdout pretty quickly, won't it? That'll get the contract negotiations going a little bit. Those 52 goals that he scored for Washington were in just 67 games. Lubomir Sakaris from Trenčín, Slovakia. Otto Haschek comes out now to center for Slovakia. He's got Kolnik on one wing. Zdeno Seeger on the other. Robert Švejla gives it back to Jurgis Bačka. Brian Leach, New York Ranger defenseman, pulls it out of the zone. Jurgis Bačka dumps it right back in for Slovakia.
Not only is the Team USA's defense very good defensively, so many of them are willing to jump up in the play. I mean, Brian Leach led the National Hockey League scoring by defenseman last year. He's always right up there with Paul Coffey and Ray Bourque.
Chris Chelios led his team in scoring last year. First time in the history of the Chicago Blackhawks that's ever happened.
Gary Suter as well, very talented offensively.
Holmes in the corner, tips it deep. Ties up Madonna. That gives Matthew Schneider time to play. Sean LeClaire out of the zone. Scott Young got tripped up, no call. Slovakia dumps it back in. Schneider put it on net. Murin made the save. Vlastimil Klavučka out for Slovakia. Far side flip to Josef Voskar. He's ridden back boards. The near point, trying to keep it in, was Yasechko. Doug Wade, who has a goal for Team USA. Into the zone for Scott Young, can't connect. Slovakia dumps it down, foot race on. Chelios and Zednik. Richter has to come out and play it. Afraid Zednik might have won the race.
Because Chelios.
Stolen in front, Richter down, backhand wide. Richard Zednik with a great scoring opportunity, has it again, stuffs it in front. Penalty call coming up against Team USA as Brett Hull touches up. We'll get a high sticking call against Team USA. Slovakia will go on the power play. 4:35 left to play in the first period. Team USA leading Slovakia 2-0.
Gary Suter gets a chance here to play with Chris Chelios, their first shift together. And look what he does to his old buddy. Gives the puck away. Mike Richter missed the puck with a big poke check. Nice little deke, but went wide. And then here's the penalty at the end of the play. Brett Hull. After the turnover, it creates turmoil in your own zone. Brett Hull coming back in to try to help out his defenseman. Gets caught. Looked more like a hook than a high stick, but regardless, it's a two-minute penalty.
Either way, Slovakia on the power play for the second time tonight. Joseph Stumpel out, centers for Zygmunt Palfi and Peter Bondra. Robert Schvela and Jurgis Bačka man the points on the power play. Sean McEckert takes the face-off against his former Bruin teammate, McEckert. Robert Schvela. Bondra for Schvela. They play catch on the near wing. Into the corner, Palfi. Stumpel battling in front. That shot blocked away by Steve Konowalczuk. Igor Murin comes out, plays it out to center ice. Stumpel hesitated, thought it was a two-line pass. They had already waved that off, however. Stumpel back to Bačka. Bailiff for Joseph Stumpel. Bothered by McEachern's poke check. Gives it up to Schvela. Shot deflected by Leach. Cleared by Konowalczuk.
Joseph Stumpel is 210 pounds. Good puck handler. Very strong on the puck. Players think they have him, and he just out-muscles them.
Slovakia a bit loose with the puck in the neutral zone. Now it's Zdeno Seeger. Shoots it wide to the far side. Otto Haschak. Deep for Seeger. Bondra stays out there at right wing on the power play. Kevin Hatcher intercepts in the corner and dumps it down.
Kevin Hatcher involved in a big trade this summer between Pittsburgh and Dallas. Sergei Zubov going to the Dallas Stars.
Here comes Kolnick again. Shot, Richter save. That one was rebounded by Kolnick with a stick above the shoulder but off the crossbar. Lubomir Kolnick has been in alone twice so far in the first period.
He's tried to go different spots on Richter, and Richter's been equal to the task every time.
Dumped in by Haschak. He gets checked. 15 seconds left in Hull's penalty time. Slovakia on the power play. Tony Amonte can't steal to come in. Sakaris plays it with the far side. Matty Buchna. Plays it back to Haschak. Hull out of the box. Team USA at full strength. Kolnick tips to the corner. Leach from Darian Hatcher goes to Brett Hull. Intercepted at the line. Kept in for the moment by Haschak. Can't drop it back to Kolnick. Brett Hull. Back to Brian Leach. Teams making changes with play between blue lines. Leach, offensive end, flips it in front. Too far in front of the breaking Doug Waite. Penalty call coming up to Slovakia as behind the play, John LeClair gets hauled down. Not much else the Slovakian player could do behind the net but haul him down there. It looks as though Richard Zednik is going to go off for 2 minutes.
USA has been a little sloppy in this game at times. Here again, Kolnick, another breakaway, tries to go short side, far side, stick side on Richter, and Mike Richter again out on top of the crease, cutting down that angle, makes another excellent save.
Richard Zednik gets the holding call at 18:09. Team USA on the power play for the second time tonight. They are one for one with a man advantage. Doug Waite's goal was on the power play. Housley for Chelios. Look at the puck movement. Housley shot, score! John LeClaire on the power play. Team USA leads 3-0.
John LeClaire at 215 pounds certainly provides a big screen, and Phil Housley is one of the best in the National Hockey League at getting the puck through a crowd of people. Doesn't waste any time, just fires a little wrist shot right in there. John LeClaire, I think, probably got a stick on it below the height of the crossbar, at least very close. Looks like they're giving the goal to Phil Housley.
Unless they're saying it was deflected in by the Slovakian defenseman. Yeah, they are saying it is LeClaire's goal now here in the building. Certainly looked that way to us, and you know what? I thought it was a good call by Mark Fossett, Gordy, to allow that goal. It looked like a legal tip. Team USA breaks. Murin makes the save, gets carried into the net. Botchka making the play on Bill Guerin. Guerin, you can see, sporting a shiner under that left eye. We understand that some of the USA-Canada games were a bit feisty.
Very emotional. Team USA certainly would like nothing better than to beat Team Canada in this tournament.
Ryan Petrovic, the team manager for Team USA, said you should have seen Adam Deadmarsh for Team USA going after Claude Lemieux of Team Canada. And a couple of months ago, they were teammates winning the Stanley Cup together for the Colorado Avalanche. Faceoff will come outside the line. They say it was Guerin who precipitated the net coming loose. 13-11, shots on goal advantage for Team USA. They lead 3-0. Goals by Doug Waite, Darian Hatcher, and John LeClaire. Mike Madonna. His own blue line gives it up. Matthew Schneider. Drilled up into the Team Slovakian bench. We got to, if we get an opportunity at some point, we have to show you Slovakia's bench. Because by my calculations, you got 20 players on the ice. They've got a coach for every four players behind that bench. They've got five coaches. A head coach and four assistants back there. LeClaire clears an offensive zone in the final minute. For Botchka. Peter Bondra out to center ice. Palfy breaks with Stumpel. Team USA has two men back. Zygmunt Palfy spins, drops it off. Schwela shoots it wide. Tony Amonte looking to send a breaking LeClaire away. Broken up by Botchka at center ice. Robert Schwela in, looking for Stumpel in the corner. Blocked off. Ryan Smolinski blocked it. Smolinski chases near corner. Backhand flips. LeClaire clears. Schwela goes back to Botchka at the Slovakian blue line. Cleared offensive zone. We're in the final 10 seconds of the first period. LeClaire clears it out. Sakaris chases back. Good wheels by Scott Young. Gets to it. Connor Walchuk in the corner. For possession as the horn sounds, ending the first period of play. Team USA took advantage of its scoring opportunities, and Mike Richter at the other end of the ice had a one-man war waging against Lubomir Kolnik. Richter stopping all 11 shots that he faced, and I think four of them came from Kolnik. Doug Waite, Darian Hatcher, and John LeClaire have given Team USA a 3-0 lead over Slovakia at the end of the first.
The United States holds a 3-0 lead over Slovakia after one period of play here at the Providence Civic Center. The USA is comprised of 10 of entirely of NHLers, and the Slovakian team has 9 NHLers on its squad. One of the key players for Team USA is none other than sharpshooter Brett Hull of the St. Louis Blues. Brett Hull, a 7-time NHL All-Star, one-time winner of the Hart Trophy and the Lady Byng Trophy, and he joins us now live here on our first intermission. Brett, first of all, you played in the Canada Cup tournament before, and the Super Bowl.
superpowers have always been Canada and Russia, but this year people are saying, hey, the Americans are the real threat. Can you outline the strengths and weaknesses of your team?
Sure. I think, you know, the reason I think our team has always been just a little behind is because we haven't had the guys like Brendan Shanahan and those type of guys that Canada has. And, now we have them. You know, we've got Keith Tkachuk, we've got Billy Guerin, and guys like that who can go in. They have the ability to score goals. They also have the ability to play tough and grind it out in the corners. And I think we'll always have the equal skill, like guys like Chelios and Brian Leach and Housley and Madonna and Roenick and people like that. I think our strength is our solid defensive defensemen and those grinding forwards.
You had a pretty short training camp and then a pretty tough schedule through this exhibition. Some like four games in 6 days.
Four games in this is our seventh day, and we went from the Atlantic to the Pacific, down to the south on the Pacific, up to the Great Lakes, and back out to the Atlantic again. So it's been a tough trip, but the guys are working really hard, and you know, they're taking it, I think, a lot more serious than I've seen them take it in the past.
Will it have an effect on the team, the tough travel schedule, maybe a lack of cohesion having such a short tournament schedule?
I don't think so. I think, you know, we went through our tough travel right away at the beginning, and I think all the other teams are going to have to do that now. And we're going to have our legs, and we're going to get a good solid week under us right here in Providence so we can get together and figure out what we want to do for the tournament. And the other teams are going to be scrambling with the travel and everything, so I think it's going to be an advantage for us.
Of course, with Team USA in 1991 in the Canada Cup, you took the silver medal. And these games really are kind of a prelude to the Olympics in 1998. Tell me how proud you are to wear the USA jersey.
Oh, extremely. I think, you know, it's an honor to be part of the team, but then when you get to throw the USA jersey on top of it and play along with the other guys from the country and play against the other countries, it's a big thrill, and I think everyone takes a lot of pride in it.
How about the growth of the game internationally with NHLers allowed to compete in the Olympics?
I think it's hockey's growing immensely, and I think everybody's doing a great job in that respect. I think we can even do more as the NHL as a league to promote it better throughout the country and make it more popular. But otherwise, it's going great, and I know everyone I talk to is really looking forward to Nagano, and I hope that I can still, in a couple years, be able to play.
I'm sure you will be. Let's switch gears a little bit to go back to St. Louis Blues talk with Brett Hall, and tell me what your thoughts were about Gretzky leaving this summer.
Well, that was probably the most disappointing thing that's happened to me in my career. To be able to play alongside the greatest guy, not only the greatest player, but one of the greatest guys I've ever had a chance to be with and play with. It's just disappointing, and I just find it so hard to believe that the organization could let him go when he really didn't want to leave. But, you know, it's just another one in a series of lost players that I've seen throughout the years.
How about your own contract status? I know you have 2 years left, but a report in the Toronto Sun this week said, hey, you were supposed to get a 3-year extension, and the Blues reneged on that deal. Is there any truth to that?
Oh, yeah. I don't want to say reneged. I think that was a deal that was made, and it was just whether the timing was wrong for the ownership or whatever. But, you know, I like St. Louis. I love it. The people are great there, and I don't want to go anywhere, so I think we can work that out, no problem.
There were reports that the Caps were interested, Chicago was interested in retaining your rights. Does that make you a little unsettled?
No, it makes you feel good. It makes you feel good about your game and that you're wanted by other clubs. And, you know, if you know, at my age, I'm 32 years old and I played a while, and you always wonder if maybe teams think that you're over the hill or not, but when they start asking about you, it makes you feel good, like you still play.
Brett Hall, thanks very much for joining us.
My pleasure, thanks.
We have much more to come on this intermission. Highlights and a game recap coming your way next. Stay with us. You're watching Prime Network. Is hockey poised to emerge as a major sport on the global stage? Yeah, if you're watching tonight's game, the United States holding a 3-0 lead over Slovakia. It is time now to take a look at our scoring recap slide from the first period. 3 goals scored, 2 on the power play by the United States. Doug Weight, who has been awesome in this tournament so far, got a power play goal to get things going at 2:49. Hull and Housley picked up the assist on the play. 10 minutes later, it was Darian Hatcher with a delayed penalty call. Smolinski and LeClaire pick up the assist, 2-0 United States. And then it was John LeClaire from Vermont closing out the first period scoring summary. Hull and Housley pick up the assist. That one came at 18-19. The United States outshoots Slovakia 13-11 in that first period. The U.S., of course, 2-for-2 on the power play. Slovakia 0-for-2 with the man advantage. Well, some of you may be unfamiliar with how the World Cup tournament works, but we're about to tell you how it works. There are 8 countries involved, 9 cities, and that's a 19-game tournament. In the first round, the North American teams will play each other once. In the North American pool, of course, is the United States and Canada and Russia and the Slovakians. And then there's the European pool. They'll also each play each other once. The U.S. opener is next Saturday versus Canada in Philadelphia at 8 p.m. In the second round, it's second-place team versus third-place team in the quarterfinals. And then the semifinals pits the first-place team versus the second or third-place winner, whoever advances from the second round, of course. The championship, which will be held the week of September 11th, pits a best-of-3 series that will be played in Philadelphia and Montreal. We have much more to come on this first intermission, so stay with us. The United States holding a 3-0 lead over Slovakia in World Cup hockey.
Team USA uses the man advantage to its advantage. Scores 3 on Slovakia in the first period and has a 3-0 lead here at the Providence Civic Center. Dale Arnold, Gordy Klusak, Brenda Brennan back here. And we said that Team USA used the man advantage to its advantage. 2 of those 3 goals were on the power play, 1 with a delayed penalty call on. Doug Waite got it rolling.
Phil Housley, great vision, picks Brett Hall right in the middle of the ice, and Doug Waite just flying down that off wing. Protects the puck with his body and just fires a quick backhand up over Murin's glove side.
Doug Waite, we told you, the only 100-point scorer on Team USA from a year ago. Goal number 2, delayed penalty call on, so the defensemen are crashing, Gordy.
Absolutely. Darian Hatcher recognized there was a delayed call, goes towards the net like he should. Puck's bouncing around, gets the loose puck, and just fires it into the open net. Darian Hatcher's played extremely well at both ends of the rink tonight for Team USA.
Richard Zednik got a holding call at 18:09 of the first period. 10 seconds later, John LeClaire got the power play.
LeClaire's in his favorite spot right in front of the net. Good puck movement here along the top of this power play by Team USA. Finally, Phil Housley just fires a little wrist shot. Doesn't have to be hard, just has to be in the right spot. John LeClaire was, and his stick just deflected it by Murin.
Team USA outshot Slovakia 13-11. Mike Richter had several great stops for Team USA at the other end of the ice. We're through 1. Set for the second period in just a couple of minutes. You're watching the United States and Slovakia World Cup of Hockey here on Prime. We're up here in the booth watching Brenda's interview with Brett Hull between the first and second periods. And Hull, always a guy to say what he thinks. He was bemoaning the loss of Wayne Gretzky from the St. Louis Blues. Ryan Leach, on the other hand, is one happy guy to have him coming to New York.
Well, certainly Wayne coming to the team is really exciting for myself and a lot of the players that have watched his career start before we were in the NHL, and then have a chance to play against him and see his success to now be his teammate, and to have him get to be friends and be around him for a year is really exciting, and he's going to certainly help our team.
Don't you wonder if Hull and Carey were talking to each other on those phones in the background? Brian Leach from Corpus Christi, Texas, believe it or not. If you're wondering about the geographic makeup of Team USA, well, we can help you out and let you know. We've told you 2 members of Team USA were actually born in Canada. I guess Corpus Christi, Texas would almost be called the West for all intents and purposes. Pretty evenly split, though, between the East and the Midwest.
I think one of the things that has really strengthened USA hockey is states like Ohio, Michigan are now developing NHL players, where before it was mainly Minnesota, Massachusetts, primarily, I guess, Michigan back then, but Wisconsin. Hockey has become very popular all through the Midwest, and you're starting to see a strengthened USA hockey program because of it.
Mike Richter from Abington, Pennsylvania. Ryan Smolinski, as you said, Gordon, comes from Toledo, Ohio. And we have not seen too many Ohio-based players in the NHL. Seth, go to work here in the second period. Both teams full strength, even-handed. Team USA leading Slovakia by a 3-0 score. Sigmund Kalpi, center ice for Slovakia. Leads Peter Bondra in. Centering pass blocked by Schneider. Bondra for Stumpel, and what a save by Richter. He robbed Joseph Stumpel point blank in front. Play at the other end. I think Richter was was as surprised as everybody else to see Peter Bondra give it up. 52 goals, only 28 assists last year. He was surprised Bondra didn't shoot. That one whistled over the glove of Igor Murin.
Mike Richter has been right on the puck throughout this game. Team USA has given up way too many opportunities. If they do that against Canada and Russia, they won't still have a shutout.
Richter covers up for the faceoff in his own end. We mentioned Peter Bondra doesn't give it up a lot. When you have twice as many goals as assists, you're not known as a playmaker, but he made a nice feed to Stumple on this play.
Well, no one can catch him. He's so fast, so he has no one to pass to. But right here, Joseph Stumple's in great position in front of the net. Left alone there, and one time did Mike Richter just did the splits and got a blocker on. There you see what Mike Richter, sixth in the NHL in save percentage.
He was also 24-13-3 with the New York Rangers. Doug Waite forechecking, had it knocked away by Lubomir Sekeres. Team USA played it back into its own end. Doug Waite, so Richter had to play it. Scott Young. He and his Team USA teammates leading Slovakia 3-0. Picked off, Zdeno Seeger tried to center. It was blocked away. Kept him at the blue line for the moment. Matty Buchna couldn't control. Buchna breaks it up at center ice. Brett Hull takes it back. Cleared in by Gary Suter on net. Murin leaves it. Otto Hasek plays it over the glass and into the seats. Far corner.
The Canada Cup was initially instituted back in 1976. Had tournaments in 81, 84, 88, I think. No, 87 and 91. There you see the USA, certainly 1991, their best finish. Mainly because they had a much more talented team back then. I mean, here, even this team is more talented than that one. I mean, five players on Team USA that lead their NHL team in scoring. That has never happened before. It just tells you how the talent, how hockey has developed in the United States.
Gary Bettman had his way. He'd probably like to see Team USA take on Team Canada for the World Cup title. That's the matchup that I think North American fans would like to see. European fans might argue that one.
I think what's great, though, is what the NHL has done by really changing it to the World Cup of hockey really expresses how this game has become so international.
Centering pass, looking for LeClaire. I think Murin got just a piece of it to deflect it away.
So many stars from so many different countries. Really is a world-class elite athlete in the National Hockey League. And the fall of communism has allowed all those players to come over and play. And it's nice to see them go back and represent their country in a tournament like this.
Richter steers to Chris Chelios. Literally arrived just this afternoon on an airplane. Steps onto the ice tonight. Walchuk can't connect with McEachern. Chelios, McEachern has Hull breaking. McEachern to the net. Hull shot, save, rebound. Turned over the net by Konowalczyk. Slovakia can't clear. Konowalczyk to the corner. Stuffs it in front. McEachern backhand shot covered up by the goaltender for the faceoff. 16:45 left to play second period. Team USA leading Slovakia 3-0.
Sean McEachern, a former Boston Bruin, now Ottawa Senator, takes the pass, feeds Brett Hull coming down the off wing. I guarantee you, Igor Murin doesn't see a wrist shot like that in the Slovakian Elite League. But he stopped it anyway. And here's Steve Konowalczyk doing what Americans do so well, crash the net, establishing body position on all three Slovakian players trying to stop them. But Murin again lays out and makes a good save.
Team USA out shooting Slovakia 18-13. So what you're saying is that at Duplett Trench, they're not shooting it quite the way Brett Hull does on a normal basis?
No, I don't think so.
Team USA, blast from the line, stops, rebound! Murin got a piece of that. You heard the pipe ring as the stick hit the crossbar. That one ripped to the net from the blue line by Leach. Stop was made, and then the rebound just wide.
You heard Brett Hull in the intermission really say that Team USA, the big difference in this team is they have the guys like Darren and LeClaire, dead marsh that can really crash the net, grind down low, and they think that'll be the difference when they're playing Canada and Russia. Here you see a great example of it. Very strong players, Garen Deadmarsh really out-muscling the Slovakian players.
Mike Pagano's a big guy at 6'3", 200. And he's got to feel even bigger with Adam Deadmarsh and Bill Guerin as his wings out there right now.
The thing about all three of them, particularly Guerin and Pagano, they can really fly.
Centering pass. Halpy tried to set it up in front for Stumpel. Halpy with it. Leaves it near corner. Schneider out from Mike Madonna. Adam Deadmarsh, Guerin to the net. Deadmarsh centering pass. Guerin missed the tip attempt. Kept in at the blue line by Schneider. Deadmarsh. Far corner, Guerin. They slip it to a breaking defenseman. Matthew Schneider couldn't hit. Rolls back to the Team USA line. And we've got a whistle. I think maybe too many men on the ice for Slovakia. That's the direction Mark Fawcett is pointing.
That's what happens when you have six coaches behind the bench.
Yeah. No, they're calling it a slash. I thought at first he was calling too many men on the ice, but Joseph Stumpel called for slashing. I mean, first of all, you got to like the fact that they're all wearing matching outfits, as Team USA's coaches are, but five of them? Joseph Galanka is the head coach.
I thought after the fall of communism, maybe they'd get a little brighter colors, but...
I'll tell you, Team USA isn't far behind with basic khaki slacks and navy blue blazers. They do spiff up their ties a little bit.
Of course, I have a brown suit on, so what am I saying?
Yeah. Captain Fashion up here ourselves, right? Joseph Stumpel and Bill Guerin get slashing penalties. Team skating 4-on-4. Jan Varholik played for Slovakia. Zdeno Seeger goes back to Varholik. Seeger checked by Darian Hasher. Clears it in. Bill Housley back takes it from Richter. Wait and Hull up front. Brett Hull has trouble controlling. Team USA offside at the Slovakian blue line. Now sticks up a little bit on the far side. That's Doug Waite more than a little bit upset with Stanislav Jasechko. Going to get a penalty call here to Waite. I don't think Jasechko is going to draw any time.
Team USA certainly very emotional in some of their exhibition games, especially against Canada, as you mentioned earlier. Doug Waite felt that, let's just say number four, gave him an extra shot there. I leave the pronunciation up to you. You
did such
a great Jasechko. Okay.
So it'll be a 4-on-3 man advantage for Slovakia. Their number one center, Joseph Stumpel, is in the penalty box. Still got Palfi and Bondra up front. Bochka is back on the blue line with Schwela. Sean McEachern, the penalty killer. Suter and Kevin Hatcher on defense, and here comes Palfi in alone. Richter runs and covers up for the faceoff.
Another great save by Richter. Pelfi gets in behind the USA defense. Richter's going to try for the poke check here. Pelfi recognizes it, tries to slip it between his legs, and Richter's able to get his pads closed just in time. Richter's had to stop about four breakaways already in this game.
Pelfi on the faceoff. USA gets control. Suter behind his own net. Not to the line, but not out. Fans on a clearing attempt. Bondra shot. Stick save, Richter. Offers it up for the draw as Palfi gets gang tackled by McEachern and Hatcher.
Palfi and Bondra are both such goal-scoring threats because first of all, they have that outstanding speed, but they're also able to shoot the puck right in stride. They don't have to stop skating to set themselves and fire that puck. They just fire it. The goaltender can't be as prepared as he would like.
Zygmunt Palfy is in a rather heated contract negotiation right now with Mike Milbury and the New York Islanders.
I'm sure it will be heated when you're involved with Mike.
Mike has not said bad things about Palfy. He has said some rather nasty things about Palfy's agent.
I don't think Mike likes agents too much.
Sakaris at the blue line for Slovakia. Far side, that's Holnick, who's been robbed a couple of times by Richter. Sakaris for Holnick. Shot, score! Didn't get stopped that time. Lubomir Holnick gets the power play goal. Slovakia cuts Team USA's lead to 3-1.
Holnick talking to himself a little bit there, saying, finally, I got one by him. Slovakia catches the USA team standing a little flat-footed. Just a screenshot here from an angle. Right by Brian Leetch and right into the far side of the net. I don't think Mike Richter saw it to the last moment. Threw a bit of a screen there. Power play goal for Slovakia.
4-on-3 man advantage for Slovakia. Teams will skate 4-on-4 now for another 25 seconds or so, and then we'll get full strength. Slovakia offsides. Hoschuk did not see the play as he had his back to the far side. Seager was 3 or 4 strides offside when Otto Hoschuk carried in. Hoschuk and Sakaris pick up the assists on the goal by Holnick.
There you see Robert Svela. I mentioned earlier what an outstanding year he had for the Florida Panthers. What a culture shock that must be, growing up in Slovakia and all of a sudden you're playing in Miami, Florida. People are throwing rats all over the ice.
You're
in the Stanley Cup Finals. You go home and talk about that, I guess.
Tony Amonte drive, save. Igor Murin holds on.
Nice to see Tony Amonte back skating well. He had a really scary injury in the playoffs. People remember really hyperextending his knee. Just comes off that off wing, fires a big slap shot. Slovakian defenseman backing in there a little bit. Murin makes another good glove save, getting down low, picking that puck up.
Igor Murin, only 5'9", 174 pounds.
What's his hometown, Dale?
Trenčiansky. That's where that French and Dukla plays. Murin covers it up and holds on. Yeah, I was noticing goaltender masks earlier. I wondered at first if Mike Richter got the job because they didn't have to repaint the mask. I don't know what is on that mask, but Mike's goes perfectly with the Team USA uniform. Because I'm not sure how much English Lubomir Sakaris speaks. Team USA will get credit for the goal and takes a 4-1 lead.
Ports on the faceoff again. Team USA wins it cleanly. Chelios just fires it across, and then good timing coming through there. I think it was Billy Guerin got the tip.
Maybe Smolinski. We couldn't really tell from that angle, but Mark Fawcett was right on the goal line. It looked as though it was redirected by Brian Smolinski. We'll wait and get the call for you. Slovakia comes out. Vlastimil Babuchka. Flooring by him. Schneider with a check. Babuchka battling with Leetch. Centers deflected. Team USA turns it out of the zone. Smolinski for Leetch on sides. Centering pass, Amonte. Shot. Pass save, Murin. Looked like he was surprised that one arrived as quickly as it did.
Defenseman loves to jump into that play when he thinks there's an opportunity for a loose puck. Doug Waite really out muscles the Slovakian defenseman here, gets position. Here's Housley, nice little drop pass, and Housley just hits the open net. Again, Doug Waite just senses that Phil Housley's coming late. Drops it right on his stick. Murin's out of position. 6-1 for Team USA. Just pick it up on a clear breakaway, gets Murin to go down, and then just holds onto the puck, calmly flips it up into the top of the net.
That's exactly what Brett Hull talked about between periods. Not only guys who can play tough, but can play, can skate, can shoot. 4 goals in 2 minutes and 35 seconds. Unassisted goal by Bill Guerin at 8:54. Don't look down and try to update your scorecard at any point. Igor Murin is going to go off, and Jaromir Dragon may decline this invitation. Dragon comes in. We had been told that he was going to play the majority of the time in net for Slovakia in this tournament. Team USA with 15 shots already here in the second period. They have scored 4. A big sigh behind the bench by poor Igor Murin, who's just looking for a place to hang his hat and sit down. Team USA with the win. Ron Ron Wilson, Paul Holmgren, John Cunniff, the coaching staff for Team USA. Keith Alain is also a coach of this team, but is not behind the bench. Picked off Zdeno Seeger for Slovakia. Centering pass, Richter save, rebound, turned off the post. Will Guerin scored a moment ago, comes out with Adam Deadmarsh. Deadmarsh rolls it deep to the corner. Guerin in, battling with Hasek. Hasek and Guerin back boards. Guerin trying to fight loose. Seeger comes in to help out now for Slovakia. Team USA drive by Darian Hatcher, stopped by Dragon. Penalty call coming up against Slovakia. Touched up, neutral zone. We're going to get a slash called against the goaltender. Jaromir Dragon picks up the call. Team USA with a 7-1 lead goes on the power play. You're watching the World Cup of Hockey preseason here on Prime.
Team USA is blowing this game wide open. 7-1 lead now, trying to make it 8. Jaromir Dragon, the new Slovakian goaltender, saw his predecessor get beat many times with the Team USA player camp right on the crease. There takes a full baseball swing at Bill Guerin's leg and gets 2 minutes for it.
Thankfully, he hit him flush on the shin pad, on the front of the shin pad. Hit him on the back of the leg with that. He might not be getting up. Power play for Team USA. Their third of the night. They're 2-for-2. Chris Chelios. High slot gives it up to Doug Waite. Chelios, one-timer, tip deflected wide. McKechnie out of the corner. Doug Waite back to Chelios. Ryan Leach. In front, McKechnie couldn't control it. Connor Walchuk to the corner. Behind the net now for Waite. Out in front for Chelios. Shot tipped twice to the far corner. Leach deep for Waite. Centering pass, stuffed at the post, covered up by Dragon. 9:24 left to play in the second, 7-1 USA with the lead.
Is there some poise on that USA blue line on the power play, or what? Chris Chelios, Brian Leach, two of the very best in the world on the power play. Put them both out there together. They're going to find the open player. They're going to get the puck on the net when they have an opportunity.
At one point, Chelios said he wasn't going to play in this tournament. Changed his mind. Pulling another roster spot open as well. We'll talk about that between periods. Amonte. Back to Kevin Hatcher. Shot. Dragon save. Amonte again. Kevin Hatcher. Far side Schneider. Matthew Schneider. Cross ice Amonte. Amonte. Battle going on in front. Fans want more shooting. Amonte. Far corner. Centering pass blocked. Dragon tips to the corner. John LeClair takes it back. Man in front breaks. Shot deflected off the Slovakian defender. Dragon had to make the quick move for the save. Amonte for LeClair. Looking in front for Smolinski. LeClair had it roll off the end of his stick. 5 seconds left in the power play. It's been entirely in the Slovakian end. Not a lot of shots, however. Just one, in fact. Slovakia back at full strength. Colden serving the penalty is out of the box. Team USA breaking. LeClair, offensive zone, flips far corner. Pass check comes out of the zone for Slovakia. Drop pass. Colden drive. Richter save. Young looking for a helmetless Doug Waite. Waite gets a run in. Young comes in, takes a shot as well. Cleared length of the ice, but they wave off the icing call. Housley back for Team USA, gives it up to Doug Waite. Back to Housley. Intercepted neutral zone by Seeger. Zdeno Seeger left it. Hatcher shot. Richter save, holds on. 7-20 23 left to play here in the second period. It's Team USA leading Slovakia 7-1. 7-1, Team USA leading over Slovakia. A little over halfway through this final exhibition game for Team USA, World Cup of Hockey. Not sure that the Slovakian fans much care about the score, to be honest with you. That group has been doing exactly what you see from the moment they arrived in the building.
70 years of communism, they finally get an opportunity to wave the flag. They're going to wave it.
Absolutely. Otto Hasjack and Darian Hatcher go off. Hasjack for slashing, Hatcher for cross-checking. Teams will skate 4-on-4. Madonna about to take the face-off against Vlastimil Klavuchka.
All right.
I've been wanting to say that one all night. I'll be honest with you, it's my favorite name on this team. Even if he hadn't played, I'd have said Vlastimil Klavuchka. Adam Deadmarsh is into the zone with Schneider. Centering feed whistled through the crease. Ryan Leach can't quite keep it in. Klavuchka for Slovakia. Rolls it between the legs of Schneider. Richter will cover it up for the faceoff. I have to admit, Joseph Stumpel helped me with some of these earlier this afternoon. I mean,
oh, you're cheating.
I have to admit that I did cheat a little bit.
Vlastimil Klavuchka is the Slovak Extra League scoring champ from the title team that won the title there, Kozic.
Yeah, in a tournament in 1993, one of the big thrills, he said, was he got to play with the Stastnys. He was second to Anton on the team in scoring. Backhand by Sean Yekker. Turned over the net by Connor Walchuk on the rebound. Varholik tips it away to the corner. Connor Walchuk. Away in the corner by Yasechko. Joseph. Oh, that's not Stumpel, excuse me. In the corner, that's Chetan, who's getting one of his infrequent shifts here tonight for Slovakia. Has not seen much ice time. Miroslav Chetan played last year with Edmonton in the National Hockey League. He's out with Pavel Dimitra, who played for the Ottawa Senators. Offsides called against Team USA. In fact, I'm not sure that we've seen Chetan since the first period. He's only had a shift or two, as you take a look at Steve Konowalczyk.
Konowalczyk, born in Salt Lake City, Utah. Another example of the broadening appeal of hockey in the United States.
Only 23 years old, which means 6 years from now, when the Winter Olympics are in Salt Lake City, he'd be 29 years old, and you got to think that would be a real dream come true for him if he could play for Team USA in his hometown. 2 years from now, of course, 1998, the Winter Olympics will be in Nagano. Penalty call coming up against Team USA. Mike Madonna is going to go off. No, Brian Smolinski. Doesn't like the call much, but Smolinski goes off.
Brian Smolinski involved in that big trade last summer between the Bruins and the Pittsburgh Penguins. Him and Glenn Murray going to Pittsburgh for Kevin Stevens, and Sean McEachern came to the Bruins. Smolinski just reaches out with his stick after having a losing little one-on-one battle and gets a tripping call. Smolinski had a pretty good season in Pittsburgh last year. 24 goals, 40 assists, 64 points. Of course, those kind of numbers get lost in the shuffle in Pittsburgh, but still pretty respectable.
4-on-3 man advantage for Slovakia. Fourth power play opportunity of the night. Slovakia 1-for-3 with a man advantage so far. Bondra in. Bochka heads for the net. Bochka tried to leave it for Bondra. Blue line. Far side, one man back for each team. Power play continues. Bondra tips it home. It is a 7-2 lead for Team USA. Both Slovakian goals on the power play.
Great little play here by Robert Svejla, breaking in, beats the Team USA defenseman. Then a screen at the end allowing Spaly to get even closer to the net. Peter Bondra just found a little opening hiding in there behind Kevin Hatcher. Nice little aerial pass right over Hatcher's stick, right onto Bondra's stick.
Two terrific plays. Bondra polished it off. But as you said, Gordy, a terrific little pass from Robert Spaly to set it up. Lubomir Kolnik back to play for Slovakia. Zdeno Seeger comes out of the zone. Kolnik breaks to the Team USA blue line. Back to Seeger. Can't control it. Scott Young comes out for USA. Wait. Centering pass. Hall was looking for Young in front. Deflected. Glove down by Dragon for the faceoff. 4:49 left play. Second. 7-2 Team USA with the lead.
Fred Hall voiced his displeasure with the St. Louis organization again this summer. There you see what he's done in both the NHL and won the MVP, the Hart Trophy in 1991. Adam Olson himself played just unbelievable hockey that year.
How about the 116 guys who were drafted ahead of him in 1984? Sixth round pick for the Calgary Flames, 117th overall.
I think the bloodlines alone would get you above the sixth round.
Wouldn't you, though? Tell you what, though, I saw him. Well, we'll tell you when we come back. 4:32 left to play here in the second period. Team USA tuning up for the World Cup of Hockey, leading 7-2. 7-2, Team USA leading Slovakia. Somebody's happy about the score. Either that or he wanted to practice his dancing. Don't you hate it when people upstage you and step in front of the camera when you got a groove going?
Billy Guerin looks like the type of guy you wouldn't want to line up against at any time, whether the score's 7-2 or 2-1. Very intense player every shift.
Born in Wilbraham, Massachusetts. First round pick for the New Jersey Devils, fifth overall in 1989. Member of the Devils Stanley Cup championship team. Long drive, Richter takes it into the midsection. Holds on, Miroslav Shatan put that one on net. Now we're happy to report that you don't pronounce names the same. Because I'd have a hard time doing play-by-play with that name if it was the North American pronunciation. It is Miroslav Shatan. Ryan Smolinski set to take face-off with Joseph Voskar. Voskar gets chased. Shatan steps in against Smolinski. Matthew Schneider for Brian Leetch. The line can't clear. Great feed. Richter, great save. Puck loose in front. Nobody can find it. Team USA comes loose. Smolinski can't clear the zone. Shatan trying to slip it in front. Couldn't make the connection with Pavel Dimitrov. Schneider gloves it away. Hand pass should have been called and finally was. 3:49 left here in the second.
Outstanding stick handling there by Slovakian center Aro Hašek off that faceoff. Team USA getting a little lazy in their own zone here. One great little move, and Mike Richter just stayed with them all the way. He's able to slide the puck back out underneath Richter, but Team USA done a good job collapsing back in front of him.
Near point for Slovakia. Shot through a screen. Richter somehow spotted it, gloved it, and held on for the faceoff. Jurgis Bochka, man who made the shot from the blue line, played last year with Milwaukee of the IHL. 74 games, had 15 points, 130 penalty minutes. When I was at least endeavoring to go over the lineups with the members of the Slovakian delegation, one of the points I think they were trying to make to me is that they don't have lines and defense pairs. They have five-men units. And for the most part, they've tried to keep Bochka and Spaly with Halpi, Stumpel, and Bondra when they have been able to. Konowalczyk. Pass Madonna. Has a breaking defenseman. Darian Hatcher rips a wrister top corner. 8-2 USA with the lead.
Something you'll expect to see throughout this World Cup tournament by Team USA is the defenseman jumping into the play late. Here, Darian Hatcher, although the least likely player of all the defensemen to do it, but does it very well. Takes a one beautiful little pass right on the ice and just one times it. A lot of velocity. Dragon had no chance.
I wondered at first if it had been tipped. I don't think anybody could tip it the way it was going through there. Hatcher gets credit for his second goal of the game. Konowalczyk and Madonna pick up the assist. 8-2 USA with the lead. Slovakia keeps it in. Zygmunt Palfik back to Joseph Stumpel. Tripped up, no call. Bondra backboards. Has one of the two Slovakian goals tonight. In front, Palfik drive blocked, and Doug Waite is down. He's the guy who blocked it. He is down and shaken up on the play. Looked like it caught him on the inside of the leg. Doug Waite, who has just been spectacular here tonight, at least on his feet. Brett Hull trying to help him over to the Team USA bench. Pete Demers, the trainer, hustles over as Waite is actually headed for the runway. That, he's not on the bench there, despite the sticks that you see behind him. He's actually in the runway that leads to the dressing room behind the bench.
I didn't see where he got the puck. Looks like he may have got it on the instep.
Darian Hatcher's second goal of the night. The media guy that's been put out for the World Cup, of course, has pictures of all the players or most of the players in the tournament. Mrs. Hatcher has got to be a little disappointed to see the pictures of her sons were flip-flopped, and they've got Kevin's picture by Darian's name and Darian's picture by Kevin's name. Darian the younger, by the way. Holman. He has a goal tonight for Slovakia. Leaves it for Seager. Centering pass tipped over the net. It was Otto Haschek who tipped it over. Centering pass. Garin couldn't put a stick on the tip attempt. Adam Detmarch.
Go, 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 come on.
Over on the near wing to try to help out. Madonna couldn't control it. Seager. Far side shot over the glove. Rebound tantalizingly loose in front. Nobody could find it. Over the glass and into the seats finally. 1:24 left to play here in the second. 8-2 Team USA with the lead.
Mike Madonna just signed a new contract extension with the Dallas Stars and went out and got Pat Verbeek in the offseason. Certainly should help what was an anemic Dallas offense last year.
Also got Dave Reed from the Boston Bruins to help with penalty killing. Some defensive work from the forward position. Chelios Kerschneider behind the net. Tony Amonte in a foot race will win it with Botchka. Amonte tried to leave it back boards for Smolinski. Couldn't connect. Tipped out of the zone by Haschek. Back in John LeClaire. So strong. One hand, backhand flip into the net. LeClaire goes back to the defense of one of his teammates who got spilled on the play. I don't believe anybody touched that one, Gordy. I think LeClaire just made an incredible backhand shot.
John LeClaire, 215 pounds, is just so strong. He just holds off the Slovakian defenseman with one hand and from an impossible angle. Backhands it. I think it deflected off Dragon's goal stick and then into the corner. LeClaire was attempting a cross goal mouth pass there. Dragon's stick was angled perfectly for LeClaire and Team USA.
to make it 9-2.
Little push one-hander in motion on the backhand with somebody draped all over you. I mean, you see it all the time. It's not really that big a deal, is it? What a goal by LeClaire, his second of the night. Smolinski. Well, they have not given LeClaire credit for the goal. They've given it to Almonte, but we'll check it later. Between periods, it certainly did not appear that it was tipped by anyone. Richter, run over in the corner. Darian Hatcher chasing around the Slovakian player. Puck is loose at the other end of the ice, and it's cleared by the defenseman out of the zone as Dragon was out of the net. 20 seconds left to play. Shot wide. Centering feed, fanned on in front. Sean McEachern breaks the other way for Team USA. Konowalczuk to the net. McEachern for Hall. Tried to feed it in front. He had a yawning net facing Phil Housley. Couldn't connect with it. Finally, the horn sounds, ending the second period of play. And what a period it was for Team USA. Mike Richter yields a pair of goals to Slovakia. But Team USA scores a mere 6 in the period. We've played 2 at the Providence Civic Center. Exhibition for the World Cup of Hockey. And it's Team USA leading Slovakia 9-2.
Boys got 6 goals in that second period and have pulled out to a 9-2 lead over Slovakia. And we've all talked about how good the United States defense is. So much for Slovakia's at this point. Canada up in Calgary, the Team Canada is having all kinds of problems on defense. Al McGinnis has lost 16 pounds with a gastrointestinal virus, so he's out of the tournament right now. Paul Coffey and Eric Desjardins both are suffering from groin injuries, so they're doubtful for this tournament. So you know what? Word is that they sent a call out to Raymond Bork from the Boston Bruins, and they had the big guy, Wayne Gretzky, place the call to see if they could beg Bork to come in and play for Team Canada in this tournament. Glenn Sather said earlier today, he said, you know, I don't know if it's fair to ask a player to come in who hasn't played a game, hasn't practiced in the entire summer. What do you think? Do you think that means that Bork declined?
Well, I saw Ray Bork on Friday, and he didn't look like he was getting ready to go play the World Cup of Hockey or anytime soon. He's deep into his off-season training regimen. He's in great shape. I'm sure in a week's time, if he wanted to go there and start skating it, he could certainly be a big contributor to Team Canada. I just think Ray had made the decision to spend some extra time with his family. He's 35 years old, entering his 18th NHL season. It's a lot of wear and tear in the National Hockey League on Ray Bork. I think he made that decision a long time ago, and I think it'll take a lot of convincing to get him to go.
Courtney, do you think part of it, too, is, I mean, he plays so many minutes for the Boston Bruins. There's so much wear and tear on the body, as you said. I think he wants to save himself for his Boston Bruins season.
Oh, absolutely. That's the key determinant. I think Ray wants to play a couple more years at least, and he's been healthy his entire career, and he wants to get off to a good start here in Boston. And he's done a lot for Canada. He's done a tremendous amount for Canada internationally. He's got nothing left to prove there, but being a Canadian, Ray, maybe you could just do it one more time for us. Just one more, huh?
Maybe Gretzky, his army, and Gore Kluzak could convince him to go play for Team Canada. How about the Americans missing Jeremy Roenick right now and holding that roster spot open in hopes that he gets his contract hassles behind him?
I spoke to Brian Petrovic, the team manager, earlier today, and he told me that Jeremy Roenick is in Phoenix today and is talking with the management of the Phoenix Coyotes. They acquired his rights from the Chicago Blackhawks. Now, they have already said they're going to match any offer that he gets anyway, that they're not going to allow him to go anywhere else. Roenick told Team USA officials he very much wanted to play for Team USA. They have a uniform sitting down there in the locker room with his name and number on it. They've kept a roster spot open. They don't have to file a final roster until 24 hours before their first game. They don't play until Saturday, so they've got until Friday for the Coyotes to get this whole thing done.
I hope they do. Meanwhile, we want to talk about some of those Canada Cup memories from the past. Of course, the World Cup used to be called the Canada Cup, and boy, there were some great memories. How about this video clip that we're about to show you?
Closing in, Rizal to Park, right in, he scores! Mark, Robert Dale, and Canada,
can hear Foster Hewitt's voice. I was in grade two watching that series. Canada shut down the entire country throughout that hockey series. It was a great comeback. Paul Henderson scored three straight game-winning goals, and it was really, it's really locked in Canada's memory forever.
Now, wasn't that Harry Sinden we saw behind the bench there?
Absolutely. There was a real Boston Bruin flavor there. Brad Park, Jean Rattel, you saw Phil Esposito, and Harry Sinden coached that team. And you could see the intensity on his face, and it was an incredible comeback by Team Canada.
And Bart Kluzek was there cheering him on from his living room set, right?
Yeah, in grade two.
In grade two. We have much more to come on this intermission, so stay with us. You're watching Prime Network World Cup Hockey. U.S. leads it 9-2. We're wondering, we're going to tell you about the United States record in international play. They've medaled 15 times at the World Championships, 8 times in Olympic play, and once in the Canada Cup. And if tonight's game is any judgment, then they'll certainly do well in this World Cup tournament also. Let's take a look at the game recap from the second period of play. Darian Hatcher picked up a couple of goals, and the USA, of course, is out 9-2 in front of Slovakia. 5 players had 3 points each so far, and the United States outshot Slovakia 21-16 in that second period for an overall total of 34-27. Power play, Slovakia 2-for-4, and the United States capitalizing both times they got the man advantage. We have more to come on this intermission, so stay with us. You're watching the United States beating Slovakia 9-2 after 40.
Seven shots on goal and 8 goals between these two teams in the second period. Team USA leading Slovakia 9-2 after 2. We won't show you all of them, but we will show you a couple of nice ones. First by Brett Hall.
Doug Waite, who's had an outstanding game, spots the little opening in behind Murin, and Brett Hall, the open net, quick snapshot. Even as he's moving away from the net, just those wrists are so powerful. One little flick and it's in the net in a flash.
Here's Darian Hatcher's second of the game.
Darian Hatcher, second goal, coming late on the play. Team USA forward spotting him, lays a perfect pass. Mike Modano, Darian Hatcher, a couple of teammates from the Dallas Stars hooking up. Hatcher just blew it right by Dragon.
Team USA leads by 7 after 2. Third period coming up next on Prime. Brenda Brennan at the Providence Civic Center, World Cup of Hockey. Now, he used to be Guy Hebert. Then he became P.A. Bear. We presume he is not from Troyes, New York, but from Troy, New York. My question is, if he was playing for Team Canada, he'd be D.A. Bear. Playing for Team USA, shouldn't he be Guy Hebert again?
I think you're probably right.
I think, though, that they actually changed Guy's name to Guy when he was a little bois. Set to go to work here in the third period. Team USA leading 9-2 over Slovakia. Look, it's preseason for everybody, okay? Let's just calm down a little bit up here. There's a guy who'd like to see things calm down in front of him a little bit. Jaromir Dragon replaced Igor Murin, who probably could not get off the ice fast enough. After he yielded 7 goals on 28 shots, we saw Igor as he got over in that spot right there with a huge sigh as he sat down. Set to go to work here in the third. Ryan Leach moves it up to the Slovakian blue line. Guerin spill from the ice, tips to the corner. Bochka checked by Dedmach. Robert Schvela, long lead, left wing looking for Palfi. Joseph Stumpel avoids the hit from Matthew Schneider. Mike Modano back to play. Bump center ice, Amante with a check in an open doorway. Dangerous there at the end of the Team USA bench. Bochka goes back and has some words for Amante.
Mike Modano's boss, Bob Gainey, is here scouting for Team Canada.
By the way, we talked to Bob down the way here between periods, and he confirmed to Gordy and I that Team Canada was in fact going to contact Ray Bourque and ask him if he'd play. He did not see what the answer was, however. Ponte kicks it wide of Dragon's net. It'll be touched up by Sakaris for the icing call against Team USA.
You consider that Team USA is showing such a great degree of offensive firepower here today. And yet Pat LaFontaine, Kachuk, and maybe Roenick could yet be added. Well, certainly LaFontaine and Kachuk will be in there when the tournament starts, and perhaps Roenick. Really put three or four lines together that have all kinds of scoring ability.
Team Canada, by the way, is tuning up against Russia tonight. Canada leading Russia 1-0. Theo Fleury goal, the only scoring in that one. Holding drive off the blocker of Richter was high and wide. Kevin Hatcher back, plays it around the boards.
I would love to see that Fedorov, Gure, McGillney line back together again. Talk about a wealth of skill.
Zdeno Seeger puts it in deep. Haschek leaves it backwards. Gary Suter plays it away to the near wing. John LeClair clears the zone past Matty Buchna. Kolnick can't play. Delayed offsides ball wiped out as Slovakia goes back to change it up.
As an NHL player, I think I've seen the best hockey ever played in this tournament. Think back to the 87 Canada Cup when Mario Lemieux and Wayne Gretzky got on the same line.
That just shouldn't be fair. I mean, that shouldn't be allowed.
That was the best hockey I've ever seen. Those three games against Russia, 3-6-5 games. Canada lost the first game 6-5 and won the next two. And with Lemieux and Gretzky playing together, it was just absolutely awesome.
Lemieux not even playing for Team Canada this year. Of course, trying to preserve his health as best he can. They still have a few guys who can play the center position, however. Lindros, Gretzky.
Sakic.
Centering feed through the slot. Pavel Dimitra slid it through the crease. Bill Guerin, front of the Team USA bench. Chelios comes back and drills his man. Chelios didn't take long to get back in midseason form. Madonna drive, look, save Dragon, and he holds on. Bochka battling in front of the net. They'll separate them. 16:46 left to play in the third.
Mike Madonna, 6'3", over 200 pounds. Great speed, firing that puck in stride. Very difficult for someone to defend against. Where he can beat you one-on-one, or he can just fire it right through a screen.
I wonder what it's like for these NHL players, Gordy. This is not like an all-star game where there's no intensity, there's no anything. You can play with a guy and go up and play against him the following week. It doesn't mean anything. But we were talking about, as the drive is taken off the blocker by Dragon, we're talking about Claude Lemieux and Adam Deadmarsh, teammates on the Colorado Avalanche, battling in one of these exhibition World Cup games, because, I mean, these things mean something.
Claude Lemieux doesn't have friends anywhere. Come on.
That's true. But, I mean, look at LeClair and Lindros. There's John LeClair. He's going to be playing against his pal and line mate, Eric Lindros, in this thing.
There's a tremendous amount of national pride on the line in these tournaments. Team Canada, certainly, Canada still provides over 60% of the NHL players. It's very important in Canada that they win these types of tournaments. But certainly the competition's closer, especially from the U.S., than ever before.
Last Emil Plavuchka taken out of the play. Even Scott plays
even though still about 20% of NHL players come from the United States, whereas Canada provides 60%. You'd expect Canada to have the edge, and they do, but not by very much.
Plavuchka shot whistled wide.
Especially on the defensive core. Team USA unquestionably has the best defense in this tournament right now. At least on paper. Remains to be seen how everybody comes together. We only have a couple of weeks, and that's awfully difficult to gel.
Shot the flex over the glass and up into the seats. 15:38 left to play here in the third. Final exhibition tune-up. Team USA leading Slovakia 9-2. schools who will play in the World Cup of Hockey. The European pool actually begins tomorrow. We'll show you both of them. Now, somebody's going to have to explain the name to me. I mean, why it's called the North American pool with Russia and Slovakia in it is beyond me. Canada and the U.S. round out that pool. And then the European pool is the Czech Republic, Finland, Germany, and Sweden.
Germany competing in the World Cup for the first time, as well as Slovakia and the Czech Republic. Of course, Czechoslovakia was in it from the inception in 1976.
We're talking about that up here in the press box. That would be quite a team, Slovakia and the Czech Republic back together, wouldn't it? Jaromír Jágr among the stars on the Czech Republic team.
The very first Canada Cup in 76, Team Czechoslovakia was the big upset team, beat out Russia.
Stumpel breaking 2-on-1. Stumpel shot, Richter save.
I still remember that 76 Canada Cup because Czechoslovakia had a goalie called Vladimir Zorilla, and Bobby Orr was the tournament MVP for Team Canada. Joseph Stumpel in here on a breakaway. Not really bearing down on that shot. Mike Richter again out on top of that crease as he has been all night long, cutting down the angle, controlling his rebound, staying up on his feet. Joseph Stumpel, 54 points last year in Boston.
Really kind of came into his own, I thought, last year.
I think he has a great future. And playing on the same team with a player like Adam Oates, just cannot help but learn how to play the center ice position at both ends of the rink. Adam Oates just sets that example, a great example, night in and night out.
I got to ask you then, Gordy. I mean, we're talking about 150 NHL players. I think Brenda said some of the best in the world. How does Adam Oates not get on Team Canada?
That is absolutely amazing to me. Or how does Adam Oates not get consideration for some of the major NHL awards year in and year out, particularly the Selke Award? And he is just the best defensive. Maybe I'm a little biased because I see him all the time, but he has just had incredible from both ends of the ring.
And I mean no knock on any of the guys who were there, by the way, when I say that. It's just hard for me to picture that he's not one of the best players.
Oh, he is, and especially when you factor in his age. I mean, how many more chances is he going to get? He's 33 years old. I think it's a real oversight by Team Canada not to bring him in.
Seager for Kolnick broken up.
Got time.
Chelios, as you heard Mike Richter saying, you got time, plays it behind the net, left wing to Suter. Dragon lets it roll. Tony Amonte gives it up to Brian Leach. Centering pass, blocked by Robert Schveler. Pass check, plays it away. Pavel Dimitra lobs it out. Leach clears it in off the stick of Brian Smolinski, wide of the Slovakian net. Jurgis Bačka plays it off the glass. Schvela dumps it offensive end. They'll wave off the icing call. Matthew Schneider back. Off the skate. That'll negate another icing call the other way. Probably not exactly what you would term crisp at this point. 9-2 with 13 minutes left in the third. Bill Housley into the zone. Scott Young, McKechnie to the net, tips. Dragon makes the save on Sean McKechnie. Dimitra checked by Young. Blue line, Darian Hatcher has a pair of goals in this one, had that shot blocked. Young deep, Housley poaching in from the blue line. Breaking away now, Slovakia. Miroslav Šetán tried the back pass to Pavel Dimitra that was blocked. Scott Young. Shot, glove, knocked down. Nobody around Dragon, but going to have to play it back to Sakaris.
The folks in Clinton, Massachusetts retreated to the Stanley Cup this season, this summer. Scott Young from there. Brought the Stanley Cup back for a big party in in early July.
Years ago, Bill Guerin did the same thing for the people in Wilbraham. That's one of the great traditions in sport. When every member of the Stanley Cup winning team gets to do whatever they want to with it for a day. Started to say to it based on some of the stories we've heard, but I think we'll leave it at with it. Hoopna plays it away to the Team USA blue line. Suter takes it from Kevin Hatcher. Joseph Voska. Nearly intercepted by Amante. Richard Zednik can't control. Matt A. Hoopna plays it away to center ice for Slovakia. Gary Suter for Team USA the other way. Long drive. Up down by Dragon. Hoopna. Boards to the near side. Flair intercepts, keeps it in for the moment, gets tied up. Slovakia clears it out length of the ice, past Chris Chelios, who will go back and touch up the icing call. Clock stop, 10:52 left to play here in the third, the World Cup of Hockey this week, the European division tomorrow. Team USA plays next Saturday. They're tuning up. Leads Slovakia 9-2 here in the third. Slovakia 9-2 here in the third. That's the good news. The bad news? Well, a couple of guys will be taken for precautionary x-rays, we are told. Brett Hull on his right foot, Doug Waite on his left foot. You saw the shot that Waite blocked. We did not see Hull leave the ice. I think Mike Keenan and Glenn Sather are sitting by the phone with bated breath right now.
Certainly, every team has the concern that a player may get hurt in these type of competitions, but the benefits to the game certainly outweigh the risks. That's why the NHL and the NHLPA support this type of event.
And the answer to your question is, if God forbid somebody were to get hurt and miss an entire season, yeah, they do get paid for their contract under that circumstance, as long as they have a contract. And that's why Jeremy Roenick isn't here right now. Does not have a contract at the moment. Chris Chelios back to play now for Team USA. By the way, Russia has come back, taking a 3-1 lead over Canada at the end of the first period. Demko scoring for Canada. They changed the scoring on the Theo Fleury goal. Flashing penalty going to be meted out here. Two-hand chop on the backhand by Tony Amante against Joseph Stumpel. Stumpel seems none the worse for wear, and Amante will go sit down for 2 minutes.
6'1", 208-pound Joseph Stumpel, age 24. He's been now with the Boston Bruins for, last year was his second season.
The problem for Slovakia in this tournament, Gordy, is he's the biggest forward they have. At 6'1", 208, Joseph Stumpel is the biggest forward on the team. And you take a look at Team USA as a, for instance, Kachuk, 6'2", 210, Madonna, 6'3", 200, Guerin, 6'2", 200. It's going to be very difficult, I think, for Slovakia just physically in this tournament to compete night in, night out.
One of the best lines I've ever read, I think it was Kent Nielsen in one of the Canada Cups, lamenting on why Sweden didn't do better in the tournament. He said they had too many Swedes.
You sure it wasn't Don Cherry? USA shorthanded. Connor Walchuk tried to steal, couldn't come up with it. Lubomir Kolnik has a goal and has been stoned about four different times by Mike Richter. Cleared it in deep. Kept in at the blue line. Matty Buchner plays it away to Sakaris. Home to Sakaris. Into the corner. Dano Seager. Checked by Brian Leach. Gives to Lubomir Kolnik. Lubomir Sakaris back to Kolnik. Shot. Richter save. Seager tied up by Leach. Seager pulls it loose, goes to Kolnik. Into the corner, Seager. Back to Kolnik. Sakaris at the blue line for Kolnik. Walks in, picks a spot. Richter's got it covered.
Mike Richter can come all the way out and challenge the shooter like that because he has confidence that his defenseman will eliminate the players behind him, which they did.
Power play opportunity of the night for Slovakia. It has about 26 seconds remaining in it. Joseph Stumpel, the man who took the slash from Tony Amante, can't control in the offensive end. Team USA clears it down. Shvela back with Jurgis Bochka on defense. Sigmund Palfi streaks through center ice. Grabbed by Peter Bondra. Has a goal tonight for Slovakia. pass picked off. Adam Deadmarsh comes out. Amonte out of the box, joins in on the play. Tony Amonte, wrist shot, gloved by Dragon, holds on for faceoff. 8:01 left to play here in the third. Team USA having its way with Slovakia, leading 9-2 in the third. See, it's good when you got the flag waving down with the lip sync. I mean, that is a skill.
Isn't that an Olympic event?
It should be. And if it was, John Tesh would have botched it. Draw to the right of Dragon, the Slovakian goaltender. Miroslav Chatan. Pavel Dimitra. Chatan shot. Richter save. Ryan Smolinski. Out to center ice. Couldn't connect with LeClaire, who just runs over his man. It's like a speed bump. That was Jan Varholics, who lost his helmet, his stick, and his way to the bench. Dimitra, drive, pad save, Richter. Kept him at the blue line. Yes, Sage going, able to pinch him from the line. Can't get control of it, however. Lubomir Sakaris for Miroslav Chatan. I always thought Chatan should play for the New Jersey Devils. It just,
you're a sick man.
It just would have had that ring to it or something. Karen just went careening into the corner with Matty Buchner. Slovakia, Sakaris. Dimitra gets the shot that's blocked. Matthew Schneider clears it offensive zone. Deadmarsh for Mike Madonna in the corner. Scott Young. Behind the net. Deadmarsh forechecking with a big bump. Madonna wrister glove down by Dragon and holds on. Hotchka and Madonna separated. Good wrist shot by Mike Madonna there.
John LeClaire, here we are in the corner. Billy Guerin coming in very aggressively, and then John LeClaire in the neutral zone as well. A couple of those big wingers make Team USA all the more formidable.
LeClaire 6'2", 215, Varholic listed at 6 foot 189. Loose to Konowalczyk. It's spinning loose for a shot. Robert Schwela for Peter Bondra. Bondra, slick little move by McEcker. Gary Suter hustles back, played away to the corner. Zygmunt Palfi drops it off. Schwela shot. Glove save, Richter.
The problem for Slovakia is they can't leave this five-man unit out there for the entire game. This unit can play with any other unit in this tournament. Bondra, Kalfi, Schwela, Stumpel,
Hotchka.
But beyond that, they just very aggressively. And then John LeClaire in the neutral zone as well. A couple of those big wingers make Team USA all the more formidable.
LeClaire 6'2", 215, Varholic listed at 6 foot 189. To Konowalczyk. It's spinning loose for a shot. Robert Schwela for Peter Bondra. Bondra, slick little move by McEcker. Gary Suter hustles back, played away to the corner. Zygmunt Palfi drops it off. Schwela shot. Glove save, Richter.
The problem for Slovakia is they can't leave this five-man unit out there for the entire game. This unit can play with any other unit in this tournament. Bondra, Kalfi, Schwela, Stumpel,
Hotchka.
But beyond that, they just don't have any depth.
Konowalczyk out for Team USA. circling back is Amonte, USA in the middle of a line change. Amonte lost it in the skates. Polnick plays it back to his own line. Yasechko moves it in far corner, USA zone. Aaron Hatch.
In fact, I expect that the average salary on that Slovakian bench probably drops off considerably after that first five guys. I don't imagine the Slovakian extra league.
That's probably a fairly safe bet on your part.
Is anywhere near in the average $900,000 range like the NHL salaries are.
Otto Hasek shoots it wide of the Team USA net. Hasek lobs it in over the shoulder of Rick. Guerin for LeClaire on the left wing. Madonna, great tip pass for Guerin. Billy Guerin in, shot save, Dragon, and he holds on. 4:10 left to play in the third. Team USA leading over Slovakia 9-2. Richter would play the whole game tonight for Team USA, and he has. Mike will also join us after the game. Faced 33 shots, some testers. Probably the sort of night you want to have in a final tune-up before the tournament starts. You don't want to have a rocking chair night out there. You want to get some action, see some shots, be able to move around a little bit.
He certainly looked very sharp. Slovakia has had probably 4 or 5 point-blank opportunities in which Mike Richter has stopped each one of them.
Madonna on the draw with Dimitra. USA gains. Schneider shot, stick save, Dragon. Cleared out of the zone by Matty Buchna. Hatcher back, touches up the icing call. While there's certainly not much riding for Slovakia here in the third period, Team USA at this point would just soon just get this thing over with as well. Brett Hull talked earlier in the night about the travel schedule. They have been all over North America. They will train right here in Providence, though, for the rest of the week until the tournament. They actually don't play till Saturday.
The travel schedule certainly gets a lot easier now.
Madonna and Chatan on the draw. Madonna gains. Schneider keeps it in. Madonna fighting for position, backboards. Buchna clears it out. Chatan dumps it in. Dimitra chases to the corner with Kevin Hatcher. Richter plays it behind the net for Adam Deadmarsh. Cleared back into the zone. Deadmarsh bothered by Dimitra. Schneider clears. Richter back boards, we'll leave it for Schneider. And away now by Chatan. Stumble, centering pass. Schrelo shot high and wide. Flipped in front, glove down by a Team USA defenseman. I think Kevin Hatcher got the glove on that one. Taken to the near wing boards by Joseph Stumpel. Peter Vondra breaks. Back to the blue line for Schvela. Konowalczuk takes it back. Chased by his Washington Capitals teammate Vondra, he dumps it in. Chipped out of the zone by Zygmunt Palfin. Leach looking for McEachern. Had it picked off by Vondra. Palfin the other way for Slovakia. Sean McEachern tips it away from Bondra. McEachern gets it himself far wing. 2 minutes left to play in the third period of this one. Team USA whooping up on Slovakia 9-2 from the Providence Civic Center. Centering pass, Smolinski. Point to find the handle on that one. Tips past Darian Hatcher out of the zone. Hatcher plays it back to Leach. Dumps it in. Team USA just trying to keep it moving. John LeClaire. Centering pass to deflected off of Monty's skates all the way back to the Team USA end. Chelios, who's been used sparingly here in the third by Ron Wilson.
You can certainly tell Chris Chelios is not in mid-season form just yet. He's laboring out there, has not played many shifts. But certainly one full week of skating will help him immensely.
Pass check, plays it ahead. Lubomir Coleman, broken up. We've got a minute left to play in the third. John LeClaire, offensive zone for Team USA. Dead march. Couldn't take the feet from Madonna. Only able to muscle it out of the zone. Center ice, plays it back to Sakaris. Otto pass check back in his own zone. Housley breaks up the play center ice. Tried to make the feed on the right wing to Konowalczyk, broken up. Housley slips it back in. 20 seconds left to play. Team USA will finish up the exhibition schedule with a record of 2-2. Beat Team Canada, lost to Canada once, lost to the Russians, and will beat Slovakia by a very wide margin. Konowalczyk comes in, there will be no more shots. Horn sounds. USA comes up with the win. Mike Richter stops 32 shots in the Team USA net. Receives the congratulations of his teammates. A pair of goaltenders down at the other end. Igor Murin and Jaromir Dragon had a little tougher night of it, Gordy.
Great tune-up for Team USA. Offensive production from a number of different players up front. Great goaltending from Mike Richter.
Mike Richter will be our guest in the post-game portion of the proceedings here tonight as he heads off the ice. A pretty easy one for Team USA. United States outshoots Slovakia 44-34 and wins this one. Final score from the Providence Civic Center, Team USA 9, Slovakia 2.
Hi, I'm Brian Collard from the Phillies.
United States skates by Slovakia tonight by a 9-2 score. And keep in mind, you haven't necessarily seen the best the United States has to offer right now. I mean, just think about it. Pat LaFontaine is out with an injury. Joel Otto is out with an injury. Keith Tkachuk didn't even play tonight. Brett Hull and Doug Wade also left in the third period. Both of those guys went to the hospital for x-rays for foot injuries. LaFontaine and Otto are also nursing minor injuries. Tkachuk missed tonight's game, of course, but he was a healthy scratch. Mike Richter went the distance in tonight's game, and he was certainly a big part of tonight's contest and will be a good source of goodwill for the United States in the games to come. It's time now to head upstairs to Dale Arnold and Gord Kluzak. What do you think Mike Richter will mean to this team?
Well, I'll tell you, Brenda, if they get to play Slovakia every night, I might have an opportunity to play in net, and that's taking nothing away from Mike Richter. I think this was the perfect tune-up game for him, Gordy. He got to see about 33 shots on goal. Some harder than others. Exactly what you want, though, to get out there and move around a little bit and get an opportunity to make some stops.
Team USA, any team that's going to win this tournament is going to need outstanding goaltending. And certainly Canada and the U.S. have the strongest goaltending contingency. Czech Republic would have, but Hašek's not playing for them. But I think Team USA has to be a little bit concerned. If they gave up that many great scoring opportunities to Slovakia, that's one thing. But to do it to Canada or Russia, you're going to find yourself behind. So I think if there's any concern at all out of this game, it's that Team USA needs to tighten up a little bit defensively. They turned the puck over a few times in the neutral zone. They overwhelmed Slovakia throughout the game offensively. But I think defensively, they need to be a little more careful with the puck, especially in their zone and the neutral zone.
Don't you think this is really a three-team tournament as we look at it going in? Team USA certainly in the mix, along with Team Canada and the team from Russia.
It's interesting. I think that is certainly they're the top three teams. The Czech Republic, Sweden would be outside contenders. Given now that they're all, and then those three big teams are in the same pool. But the way the playoffs work, the second team from one pool will play the third team from the other pool. The top teams get a bye. So it could be any two teams could end up in the final. So I think it would be exciting to have a Canada-U.S. final. But I think you could just as likely have a Canada-Russia. Russia or U.S.-Russia. Any one of those three games, I think, would be a great spectacle for hockey.
Well, Gordy talked about the scoring chances that Team USA gave up tonight that they can't afford to give up when they're playing Canada or Russia. The guy who would likely have to be facing those is downstairs with Brenda Brennan right now, goaltender Mike Richter.
Yes, Mike Richter is joining us now live on the post-game show. Mike, tell me about tonight's game.
It's our last exhibition before we get into the real stuff, so we wanted to make sure that it's nice to get a win just to feel that you can do that. You go three periods. We thought we played pretty well in the last nine periods that we played, but we only got one win out of the three games, so it was important to get at least a W tonight. But really, we wanted to play a little bit more sound, and I don't think our first two periods were exactly what the coach wanted, but we settled down by the third. Of course, they were tired, and so were we. We've played a lot of hockey this week, and I think it's a high note going into the real schedule, so we're excited.
Now, you played in each one of the four games so far this exhibition. Are you tired yet?
Yeah, I think that's a message from the coach, get in shape. I love getting all the work I can. When you're off for the summer, I like going as long as I can without playing. But once the season starts, I like to play all the time. And you keep yourself in shape by all the workout programs that your respective team's giving you. And I forgot my own workout schedule that I've been doing my whole life. So I felt I came in pretty good shape. But there's always that adjustment actually playing the game. So this is my first 60-minute full game that I've gone, and I felt pretty good.
Did you feel you faced a lot of tough shots tonight from the Slovaks?
Yeah. The Europeans nowadays, I mean, everybody's got high-quality shooters, and these guys play pretty darn wide open, and we pretty much knew that was going to be the case, and they're a scary team. They can get a lot of chances like this. You got Palfi and Bondra. I mean, these players are great players in the NHL, and the European leagues are great, too. So these guys have skill. I mean, you really have to honor them, and just because it doesn't say Russia on the front or Canada doesn't mean this team's not capable of beating you, and we had to respect that, and we did, and we were able to win.
How about the United States defense getting a boost tonight with Chris Chelios back there on the blue line? What does that mean to this team?
He's unbelievable. You know, he came in, he was getting a physical between periods, and, I mean, he looked like he hasn't missed a step out there. It's just amazing to see a guy that talented can come out and not lose an inch of his ability, it seems, after not playing for so long. But he means a lot more than just the talent he brings to our team. He's got a lot of composure and obviously a great leader. And he's one of the few guys in the league you can say he's actually a force on defense. I think we had an excellent defensive core before he came here, and now that he's here, that's a huge stabilizing factor for our team. So we're really looking forward to have him join and make a contribution, but we're happy with our team right now, and it's just a matter of how well we do in the next three games.
Now, you've had the honor of playing for the United States in both the Canada Cup, the 91 silver medal winning team, and, of course, you played in 1988 in Calgary in the Olympics. Tell me how this tournament will be compared to on par with those.
You can never quite say that anything has the same amount of buildup as the Olympics does. The Winter Olympics isn't quite what you see in the summer. It's just a smaller whole venue. But, I mean, playing for your country in the Olympics is a really special moment. But, you know, now you go into this tournament, and in some ways it's a little bit more of an honor in the sense that you are playing against the absolute best in the world. We have the best team we can field. Canada does too. Russia does too. They're talking that they've had the best team since that USSR team, the last one of Fedosov and all, broke up. So, I mean, you are playing the best in the world, and I think that's a lot better than the World Championships. No disrespect to them at the end of the year, but this is the top, top team. So it's a huge honor. And how it compares, I think it maybe doesn't have as much respect in the public, but in the hockey world, people know that this is the best tournament you can possibly be in, and they respect it as such.
Let's switch gears a little bit to talk about your team. The New York Rangers went out this offseason and got the big acquisition in Wayne Gretzky.
Yeah, unbelievable. I mean, it is just so exciting. Every year we seem to make a few trades that changes the complexion of our team for the better. But this year, I mean, what can you say about having Wayne in your team? There's two components here. This is the best player maybe who's ever put on a pair of skates. It's like asking a baseball player, would you like to have Babe Ruth in your clubhouse? Well, you know, Wayne's going to bring a lot to our team just because of how much experience he has and what a great leader he is on and off the ice. But he also looked, and he had over 100 points last year, so he's still one of the top players in the league. It's just a little bit unfair. He's being compared to what he was at 24 and 25 years old, and that's going to be a tough thing to do. But he'll bring a lot to our team. Just his sheer talent's so incredible. But his leadership, I just can't wait to be in the locker room.
Mike Richter, thanks very much for joining us tonight.
Yeah, thanks.
Mike Richter, the player of the game with 32 saves on 34 shots tonight. Now it's time to head back upstairs to Dale and Gord.
He had a couple of interesting comments about the caliber of play in this as compared to Olympic Games and World Cup tournaments. A couple of things. First of all, I almost expect a drop-off in the play of many of these guys at the start of the NHL season, because they're going to be at such a higher level emotionally. It's going to be tough to face a regular season game against San Jose on a Thursday after you've just played in the World Cup of Hockey.
I think you're right, Dale. But like Mike alluded to, it's such a challenge and an honor to represent your country when you know in the hockey world that these are the best players in the world. And when you're representing your country, I did it in the World Junior Championships, it takes it to another level emotionally. I know how important this tournament is in Canada. It's followed more closely than you can imagine. And I think if Team USA really starts contending and gets in there, that the interest will pick up in the United States too. And I hope that that happens, because your hockey fans, true hockey fans, know the quality of this competition. And I hope that more and more people start to recognize that.
Are we getting an Olympic preview? Nagano, 1998, for the first time NHL players will be allowed to compete. Is what we're seeing here just a preview of what we'll see 2 years from now?
I think that's a great move by the NHL. I know we disagreed on that a little bit last year. But going to the Olympics to show the world what hockey is, and that there's no one dream team. Russia, U.S., Canada, even the Czech Republic, all of those teams have opportunities to win the gold medal. And hockey is really a worldwide sport, and it'll be a great spectacle for the NHL.
An easy win tonight for Team USA, their final tune-up before the World Cup kicks off. Well, actually, tomorrow in the European bracket, on Thursday in the North American bracket. Doug Waite leads the way, offensively at least, but a whole bunch of other people chipped in. Final score, Team USA 9, Slovakia 2.
From the Providence Civic Center, Slovakia 2, the United States 9. The United States got 3 first period goals, and then the floodgates opened wide in the second period. Let's take a look at our scoring recap, our game recap slide right now, and we'll see that in the second period, the USA got 4 goals within a 2-minute, 25-second span from Brian Smolinski, Brett Hull, Phil Housley, and Bill Guerin. That chased Igor Murin, who allowed 7 goals in that span, and Darren Hatcher, Tony Monte added late goals in the second period. It was 9-2 after 2, and that's the way it ended. Mike Richter goes the distance, has 32 saves on 34 shots. The United States now 2-2 in World Cup Hockey Exhibition, and they'll have their opener next Saturday. More to come in just 2 minutes, so stay with us. Team USA is entirely made up of all NHLers, as is Team Canada. Slovakia has 9 NHLers playing in this tournament, and the only team without an NHLer on the roster is, you guessed it, Germany. So you can see how that one will even out during this tournament. 7 former Olympians on this USA squad, 11 former Canada Cuppers on this USA squad. 10 of those players played for Team USA when they won the silver medal back in 1991 in the Canada Cup. This is the entrance to a couple of exciting weeks of World Cup play. The United States opens next Saturday at 8 p.m. in Philadelphia versus Team Canada, and you can bet that'll be a great game. Again, this isn't all-star hockey. This is a battle for world supremacy, a real battle going on right now. All the stars are coming out for this one. 8 countries in 9 cities competing over a 19-game schedule. For Dale Arnold, Gord Kluzek, and the entire Prime Network team.
Much noise. He basically just sit there and make sure that his shoelaces were nice and neat, and that his tape was not overlapping on his pads, and, you know, make sure he looked good before he went out there, and just had the knack of, as I said, staying very calm, cool, and collected, and, you know, he scored some big goals in the playoffs for us in the overtime games, Los Angeles in 1980 against Edmonton the year before, so this was a position that Kenny was used to, and maybe we should have looked at Kenny to get the goal, who knows?
Well, the goal itself, the puck seemed to have eyes. I mean, it was like a China wall in front of Glenn Hamlin.
Well, as hard as Kenny shoots the puck, he needed somebody to get in the way and screen the goalie, because he knew it wasn't going to blow by him on his own. Goals are scored in different ways, and it was the right shot at the right time and obviously in the right place, and we were very, very fortunate.
Elation.